Alright, so what's up chats, kaise ho bhai jan, gandus, today we got a couple of stories at our hands. We got news about the PS5, and we're hearing that PS5 is gonna run hotter than the Xbox Series X. Now, I know that I'm gonna be offending a lot of people with this one, but understand that I'm just reporting the news, okay? Like, personally, I'm a Sony pony, I'm also gonna be getting the Xbox. Like, needless to say, come November, it's gonna be a gamer's heaven month. We're just talking about pieces of plastics, guys, so don't get offended, okay? I'm just simply reporting the news, and the news is kind of good, actually. Like, got a lot of really good stories about the PS5 in this video. We also have news about the PS5 US, so definitely stick around for that one. And we got a ton of people mad about Black Ops, okay? I mean, it's another year and people getting mad, and the tweets that I'm seeing right now, man, people got no chill, all right? And with that, I just want to get right into it. If an alpha child like you is new here, I cover all the big gaming news, so garne me subscribe mardo. And our first story is about the PS5. We're hearing that PlayStation 5 runs hotter than Xbox Series X, with the PS5 peaking at 65 degrees Celsius, according to unconfirmed report. And I'm sitting here, I can confirm it to you right now that yes, it's gonna run hot. It's gonna be a hot boy. But ladies and gentlemen, both of these consoles are gonna be consuming a lot of energy. They are literally computers, okay? So they're surely gonna run hot. Personally, I want them to run hot, you know? Like, I'm living in Canada, and during winter time, it gets really cold out here. So you know what? I like to have my PS4 jet engine around, leave it on for 1-2 hours, sit in a Modern Warfare lobby, and boom, your whole room is hotter than Sahara Desert. And personally, I'm happy that my room will be, you know what, quote-unquote toasty, because of the PS5 and Xbox Series X. And you know what, come summertime, yo, it's gonna be barbecues time. You guys already know that. These are facts, no printers. Smash a like button if you know these are facts. But this is coming from Roberto. He says that PS5 is gonna be from 55 to 65 degrees Celsius hot, and Xbox Series X is gonna be 52 to 62 degrees. Xbox bought a cut 3 degrees Celsius. I mean, these are numbers, right? So I know that some people will be laughing, and if you're an Xbox player, don't laugh, okay? Like, it's just 3 degrees. It's just 3 degrees Celsius. Both of these consoles are gonna be good. We're just talking about pieces of plastics at this point, right? Like, let's be happy that it's coming out next month, rather than fighting over consoles. On the other hand, Devil May Cry 5 takes about 4 seconds to load on PS5, and on the PS4, it's gonna be taking 22 seconds. And this clip was posted by, like, I believe this is a Japanese YouTube account. Like, I could definitely be wrong. Like, duh, like, I don't speak Japanese. And in this clip, we got a chick out here that is looking thicker than a Snicker, okay? Like, when I say beauty, I just gotta appreciate. And you know what, that person just started the game, so you will see that it will take about 4 to 5 seconds, and boom, he's in the game. Personally, I love seeing that because I'm thinking about GTA 6. You know what, I like thinking ahead, and of course we're gonna get GTA 6 when we're 80 years old, right? We're talking about Rockstar Games. Like, let me keep a buck 50 with you guys. The open world games design is gonna change substantially, right? Just because of the SSD. And I think that in the coming years, because we're talking about, this is still early stages, right? And they have not yet optimized the games fully. And I think in the coming years, they're gonna be able to optimize the games down to the core teeth. And I think that's when we're really gonna see their true power. Because yeah, 4 seconds is very good, but we're still like early stages. So that's what I like to see, right? Sony is also clarifying that cross saves for games on both PS4 and PS5 are a developer decision. And we got the direct quote. It says that, please note that the ability to transfer game saves between a PS4 version and a PS5 version of the same game is a developer decision and will vary title by title for cross-generational games. It's the same thing, right? Some game devs will be choosing like 60 FPS, and some game devs will be like, you know what, go pound sand, we only want to keep a 4K 30 FPS, okay? We're also hearing that PlayStation Store on the web and mobile is gonna stop selling like the PS3, PSP, and Vita games this month, and apparently the change is gonna happen on the 19th, starting 19th of October. Sony will stop literally all the add-ons for the PS3, plus the games, the PSP games, the Vita games, the apps, themes, avatars. Seriously, we do not know why Sony is doing this. We can still buy like the PlayStation 3 games on the PlayStation Store, but on the PS3 on its respective system and whatnot, but we're not sure why Sony is doing this. Like, we know that Sony always like to do helicopters with their woolies. Maybe their neurologists and psychologists were like, hey, you gotta stop selling the PS3 games, the PSP games on the PS5 PlayStation Store and the PS4 PlayStation Store, because this way you're gonna make more of money. That can be a possibility, but at this point, I mean, nobody knows. Now, speaking of Black Ops, a ton of people are sad and mad about skill-based matchmaking, and it's once again trending over on Twitter. And I'm gonna show you like a couple of examples, okay? This article is talking about people are sending themselves to heaven. Obviously, I cannot say that word on YouTube, right? People are sending themselves to heaven over and over in a bid to improve their experience with the game, right? And you know what? Meet Eric, okay? This is a homie from the streets. He kind of added me in the situation. Says that Skizzle, this pick on the left is my first time playing, and then pick on the right is basically every game I had after that. Skill-based matchmaking is crazy. Tick! I played for over an hour and never went positive again. Looks like it's campaign and zombies this year. That's what it is. And a little bit of Warzone. Smack in my head. He kind of added me in the situation, dropped a photographic evidence. And in the first picture, you can see the man is getting a kick of dopamine. He's like killing everybody. He's finessing everybody. He's feeling on top of the world. He's smelling his own farts. You know what I mean, right? And on the right, well, the homie's getting gangbanged by like literally everybody in the game. And I'm gonna keep a buck 50 with you guys because the amount of time I heard this story, I would be a millionaire, okay? And obviously, do not count how many times I said a buck 50 in this video. Like, just don't do it. You're at the end of the day, you're only gonna get 5-6 bucks, okay? Like, let me keep a buck 50 with you guys. But seriously, dog, my first game on the beta, I was literally finessing everybody. It was almost as though I was going against the bots, and then it was like, hey, I was the bot after. I was getting dunked on pretty hard, okay? And you know what? Like, we got Drifter out here. You know what? Drifter, we got Dismo out here, says that I'm in the same boat because Drifter says that. And you gotta understand that this man swims in G Fuel every single day, okay? These like Call of Duty mathematician out there says that I'm going to take a breath and a short break before making my beta impressions video. This has been a very rough morning for me so far. Not happy with a lot of what I experienced in the beta. Actually kind of preferred the alpha. I mean, damn, son. And you know what? Like, we got 402 Thunder out there, you know, dropping some salt. And literally, you can see, like, everybody's out there. Everybody's dropping deuces. And even Exclusive Ace, this is the Mr. Positive in Call of Duty alongside Prestigious Key. And he says that I'm trying so hard to enjoy this beta. And I see the potential, but it just feels off. I constantly feel like I die in 1 to 2 bullets while half of my shots don't register at all. Something has to change. And keep in mind, I haven't even shown you guys like other people's opinions. Like, you know, YouTubers are keeping it on the low, okay? And I think there's a connection problem as well, because sometimes like I run around, I find somebody, I'm playing like a god on my screen, like I'm spraying bullets, and then I get finessed with 1 or 2 bullets. It's almost as though I gave the other guy the ownership. And you know what? Skill-based match, we get like, look at these responses. We got like different languages and whatnot. Now, speaking of the PlayStation 5 UI, you know what? This happened a week ago, and I want to still show you guys this clip real quick because this is something that has not been debunked, okay? Some people obviously think this is fake, other people think this is legit, and I personally am in the very middle, okay? I think this is possibly legit, but of course nobody knows, right? And the guy claims that he paid about like 100 euros to somebody who has like the PS5 early, and he paid him 100 euros to get this clip, and I'm sure he probably would have made his money back, right? And this was the clip. To me, it looks legit, okay? But still, it can be fake. But here's the thing, man. This happened 8 days ago, before we had the PS5 teardown video. And this will open up your third eye, okay? Of course, we got these images as well. But we also had these images. Now, keep in mind, this is the PS5 shell. Obviously, it is very easy to fake. You can easily fake this one, right? But the fan in the back, that is pretty hard to fake. Like, I'm not gonna lie. Like, how did they know that this fan is gonna be inside the PS5? And I'm just gonna put, like, a side-by-side comparison. And keep in mind, this was leaked before we had the official teardown from Sony. So this picture right here, 100% bona fide, 100% legit. And also, take a look at this. Like, this is a PS5 stand, okay? It looks pretty legit to me. And this was leaked before we had the teardown video. This is how it's gonna look when you place the stand on the PS5 when you're looking to place it horizontally, right? I mean, duh. So now, coming back to this leaked video, I'm not sure. I'm kind of sus. Of course, it can still be fake. You know, I'm not saying that this is 100% legit. But in my honest opinion, of course, I'm not a scientist. I don't work for the Sony ponies or anything like that. To me, it seems genuine, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and say that this is 99% accurate, this is 99% legit, and I'm gonna throw this argument in the mix just for the sake of arguing here, because I think this video is legit, but we're not sure how old or new this video is. What if this video is like super old, right? That is a possibility, right? Or what if this video is taken recently, but still Sony hasn't finished up the UI yet, and Sony can always drop a new update? What if this is a placeholder UI, and Sony actually has the real UI, but Sony hasn't dropped the patch yet, and once they drop the patch, it's gonna look completely different from this one? That is always a possibility, but now it seriously looks like that this is the legit UI video we have seen. But share your expertise in the comments below, like and subscribe. I'ma keep a stud muffin like you always in the loops. Click on a video on the screen, and I will see you right there. Stud muffin out.